Unit 4, Phase 6, Paul imprisoned in Jerusalem and Caesarea. So as we go into Phase 6, we're actually going to see, we're going to break it into two parts. So this first part, we're going to look at Paul as he leaves Ephesus and comes down to Jerusalem to preach Christ. And then in our next unit, we're going to look at kind of the second part of that, which is where he goes to Rome. So but if we look back at Ephesus before he leaves, remember, he's there with the church in Ephesus, who he has spent about 2 years with preaching and ministering, and they don't want him to leave because they're never going to see him again, and they're worried of what's going to happen to him if he goes to Jerusalem. But Paul answers them and says, "What do you mean by weeping and breaking my heart? For I am ready not only to be bound, but also to die at Jerusalem for the name of the Lord Jesus." And so Paul knows that he is kind of heading into the lion's den, as it were, but he is prepared to go to Jerusalem, and he leaves. And we see him in Acts 21. He's preaching in the temple, just like Jesus did, and he gets arrested. So the Jews oppose his message. At the later part of Acts 21, he actually requests to speak, and Paul gets the chance to publicly share his conversion story there, but he also reveals during this section that he is a Roman citizen. So after that, chapter 22, Paul is then taken before the Jewish leaders, and he is interrogated there. And what we notice is actually the treatment that Paul gets is actually very similar to how Jesus was treated during his trial and final days as well, which is interesting. But in Acts 23, we see that there's a plot that develops to kill Paul at his trial. So he requests the trial, and they say, "Okay, tomorrow we'll give you a public trial." But during the night, there is this plot to go and kill Paul before that's ever going to happen. And word of it gets found out, and he is transferred out of Jerusalem to Caesarea. So he's protected as a Roman citizen, but he's still a prisoner. And so now he leaves and he goes over to Caesarea as a prisoner. And here he appeals to Caesar and to Herod Agrippa. And you can see that amazing account in chapters 24 through 26 there. So at the end of chapter 26, it's basically decided that Paul, as a prisoner, is going to be sent to Rome. And so as a prisoner, Paul leaves Caesarea, where he has been imprisoned, and he finally goes to Rome, which has been his goal. And the road to Rome is very rough. He gets shipwrecked on an island of Malta, but he ultimately makes it. And Paul spends about 2 years in Rome under house arrest. So he is technically a prisoner, but he has a fair amount of freedom there. And we see that he is again preaching Christ every chance that he gets. So if we go back to our timeline, we kind of left off previously looking at Paul's third missionary journey. Takes place right there from 53 to 57. We see the next event there is Paul's imprisonment in Caesarea, roughly 57 to 59. But now we know that after Caesarea, Paul is going to make what we're calling his final missionary journey. So we know that he has been planning and plotting to go to Rome, and though it's probably not the circumstances he wishes, he is heading to Rome. So in our next unit, let's see kind of what happens when Paul gets there, as well as the letters that he writes from Rome. And so join me in Unit 5 as we look at kind of the second half of Phase 6, which is from Rome, Paul's final letters to the churches.